This is your instructor Shirley Steele for another edition of Body Sculpt. And this morning I'd like you to grab two sets of weights. We're going to have small or medium, medium or heavy, a little combination so that you can work the stronger muscles that are able to lift a heavier weight and knock it down to lighter weight if you have any shoulder issues or any modifications you need to make. Always we want to challenge yourself to get that little bit stronger, so don't stay with the same weight. I've been doing the same weight, Shirley, for 3 or 4 years. No, let's challenge ourselves to go a little bit more, all right? So we have a couple of sets of weights and we have our water because we need to keep hydrating. So this is going to be an upper body workout and we're going to start with lighter weights for the shoulders. So if you have very, very strong shoulders, you can go a little bit heavier. Remember, as we get to our second set, you can lighten the weight, and if you choose to do a third set, you can further intensify and do more for the muscle group. I'm going to start with light weights, but first of all, we are going to warm up our body, okay, before we get started with the light weights. So, heels back, inhale through your nose, and out through your mouth. You want to keep your core tight. Inhale, exhale. Okay, little elbow to knee, up, out to the side, out to the side. Keep breathing in through the nose, and out through the mouth. Step touch. So it's important to warm up the body before we lift weights. You don't want to just come in cold and start lifting. Crisscross the arms, step touch the legs. Very good. Okay, heels back again. Back. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Do it again. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. Three. Bring it elbow to knee. Give it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Do it again. Give it 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Step touch. Move back behind. Arm presses. Pulls back. Do it again. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. We're going to do lateral stretch. We're taking it side. Join me. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Switch it. Here we go. Take it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And faster movement. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Do it again. Give me 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. And march it out. March it out. Hands on the thighs. Flat back. Round your back. This is your standing cat and cow. Round the back. Come up. Flatten the back. Round it. Flatten it. Again. Round and flatten. Round and flatten. Roll it. Roll the shoulders. March and roll the shoulders. Good. Roll them, roll them, roll them. Give me 4, 3, 2, and 1. Take a wide stance. Stretch your shoulder. Bring the arm across the chest. Go behind the elbow joint. For 4, 3, 2. And switch. Bring it across. Stretch. 4, 3, 2. Bring it up. Tricep stretch. Chin up off the chest. 5, 6, 7. Switch to the other side. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. And one long stretch. 4, 3, 2, 1. Switch. 4, 3, 2, 1. So that is a sufficient and ideal warm up for the upper body. Grab some water. Right, so keeping hydrated is really important during exercise. Light weights. Start with the littles or mediums. We're going to do a sidearm shoulder raise, double sidearm raises. 1, two, three. So to intensify this, four, you're going to lift heavier weight, five, providing, six, your form remains good, seven, soft elbow, eight, that means slightly bent, nine, 10, I want you to squeeze your middle back for five, four, three, two, and one. We're gonna go front side, okay? So front side horizontal weight, here we go. Together, one, two, if that's too light, consider a slightly heavier weight. Three, four, keep the form. Five, nice and tall, no arching of the back. Six, exhale, seven. Eight, nine, 10, five to go. Four, three, two, and one, nice job. So as we go to overhead press, because I'm keeping it as a trio or a tri-set, I'm going to choose a heavier weight. My overhead press, most of us can usually do that a little bit more over the head. If that's not the case for you, stick with a lighter weight. If you feel you can go a couple of pounds more, go for that. Nice light grip on the weight and pressing up and over the head. One, two, you could add a calf raise to that. Three, four, abdominals are tight. Five, at no point can we arch. Six, seven, eight, nine, 10, five to go. Four, three, two, and one. Nice job. We'll track from side to side. That's our first tri-set. Set of shoulder exercises. Supersetting or tri-setting one after the other. Three different muscle groups. Back to the first one. Back to your side arm raise, your lateral arm raise. So a couple of things you can do here is the double side arm raise, squeeze the middle back, slow it down. One, you can alternate. Two, three, if the weight's a little heavier. Four, keep the head up. Five, exhale the lift. Exhale, belly back to spine. Six, seven, eight, nine, 10, give me five, four, three, two, and one, and down, and drop side to side. Five, six, seven, eight. Roll the shoulders back. Okay, the shoulder front raise, second set, is either alternating like so, or you can do them together, but it's a vertical raise this time. Two, three, abs are tight. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, five to go. Four, three, two, and one, side to side. Four, three, two, and one. Consider coming up a weight, a pound or two for the overhead press if you can. If you're absolutely not able to go any heavier, we'll stick with a lighter weight, 90 degrees start and finish point. I'm gonna start you like so actually here, and then we're gonna press it at the top. So you're gonna come down to here. Turn and press two, turn and press three, turn and press four, five, don't arch the back, six, abdominals are tight, seven, eight, nine, 10, let's go, five, four, three, two, and one, good job, side to side, dip, 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 four, three, two, and one, good job, roll your shoulders. So this next exercise I'm going to have you do with very light weights or no weights. I'm going to show you with no weights. It's called, I call it alligator jaws. It's for the rear delts, the back of your shoulders. The arms are extended at shoulder level. That gator, alligator, open. Squeeze one, squeezing the middle back. Two, exhale, three. Abs are tight. Four, weights or no weights. Five, try to keep the arms at shoulder level. Six, seven, eight, 9. This is all upper body. 10. Give me 5. 4, squeeze the rear delts. 3, squeeze the middle back. 2, keep your shoulders down. And hold it. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Good. Notice the palms were like so, opening up. We're going to change that on our next set. Okay? So this time we're going to be shoulder level here. The palms were like that before. Now we're here. Open and squeeze 1. Weights or no weights, 2. Stand tall, squeeze 3. Keep your neck long, 4. Reaching from the crown of the head, lifting from the waist. Give me a good squeeze back there. 7. 8. Relax the neck. 9. If it gets tired, relax the shoulders. Give me 5. 4. I have no weights, I feel it. 3. 2. And 1. Take it down. Side to side. Woo! Breathe. Yes. It's time for water. Keep hydrating. Let's sip the water. Good. Just keep moving. Okay, keep moving. Next one is requires a heavier weight. This is the reverse fly, so ultimately working the middle back, but in order to get there, we're pulling on the front of the shoulder. And we're doing this after we've done shoulder exercises, so be mindful of that, but do remember that your back is squeezing as you pull back. It looks like this. So don't confuse that with this, okay? It is this. It is this. All right? Knees soft, abdominals tight. If you're not sure on that, get with your personal trainer, get with me, check on me with me on exactly how to do that. Pull back 1, slow. 2, 3, you can use a lighter weight. 4, if you're feeling strong. 5, leaning forward to activate the core. 6, I could do it standing up tall. 7, 8, but I'll eliminate a bit of the core work and a bit of the gluteal work. Give me 5, so I like to lean forward. 4, that nice form. 3, 2, and 1, good job. Side to side, side to side. We're going to substitute the large for the lights. So the lighter weights, we're going to do a simulated chest press. Okay, from 90 degree arm press. Weights or no weights, light or medium. Press 1, inhale. 2, retract the shoulder blades, stretch the chest and shoulders, working together. 3, 4, 5, feeling heavy, shake the head. 6, 7, weighted chest press. 8, using dumbbells. 9, 10, 5 to go. 4, 3, 2, woo! And 1, good job, side to side. As we go back to the second set of reverse fly, decide if you want to use the heavy weight again or the medium weight, or if you're going to break it down a little bit. Listen to your body. If it's muscular, challenge yourself. If it's something with the joint, be careful. So the reverse fly weights, you can use the heavier ones or the littles. Here we go. 1, 2, I'm leaning forward, flat back. 3, abs are tight. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 5 to go. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good. I felt my hamstrings, my glutes, and my core there as I was leaning forward. My belly button was to spine to support the low back. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Weighted shoulder press, chest press. If you want to bring the arms down slightly below the shoulders as a modification, you can. Core is tight. 1. See how we're keeping this flowing? 2. We're not stopping. 3. And 4. Unless you hit the pause button. 5. 6. We're keeping it going. 7. 8. 9. 10, 5 to go, 4, 3, 2, and 1, good job, good job. Take a little breather, roll side to side. Keep breathing in through the nose, out through the mouth. Don't forget to keep the core tight. Four, three, two, and one. Good job, good job. Place that down. We're going to heavier weights. We're talking biceps and triceps. Bicep and tricep. So that's our heavier weight. So I'm going to give you three options for bicep and tricep. The first one is angled curl. So you're going out this way, so you're going to feel a bit of your shoulder. And what we might do is keep Pilates V and look, draw those inner thighs together, squeeze the glutes, draw the abdominals in. And as we're raising the arms, we're going to raise the feet. All right, do it with me. One, two, squeeze the glutes. Feel the inner thighs squeezing. Three, angled bicep curl. Four, look at my positioning of my arm. Five, six, curl it up, curl it down. Seven, eight, don't forget to squeeze the glutes. 9, 10, abdominals are tight. You're growing as tall as you can. Reach from the crown of the head. Four more, abdominals tight. Three, two, and one. Good, we're gonna stick with the biceps. We're gonna stick with the biceps. You're looking at least a medium weight to heavy. Medium to heavy, depending on how much you have worked out this week and how strong you're getting. Hopefully you're becoming stronger with time. All right, so the next one is a hammer curl. So as we go up and down on the toes, we raise the weights the same way. It's a vertical lift. Nice weight grip, but not super strong grip. It's enough to hold the weight and squeeze the bicep as you lift in the forearm. Here we go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Can I get five, four, three, two, and one? Good. So dip side to side, dip side to side. For four, three, two, and one. Good job. Bring your shoulders back. Then we'll do your traditional horizontal bicep curl. You can go up and down on the toes. With that full arm extension, you can be out to the side or you can be slightly in front. You don't want your elbows to come in though. Elbows by the sides. Here we go. One, two, three. You want to feel that four on the bicep strengthening in five, six. You want to build some strength in the arms. Seven. Add a little more weight. Eight. Nine, remember you can always alternate. 10, if it's too heavy. 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Okay, dip side to side. Good. Four, three, two, and one. Let's do triceps before we get some water. Leaning forward once again, hips are back, elbows are by your side. Closed and nice and tight. Straight arm kickbacks. One,
which is up and down one. You can choose
choose to drop them down and out on the toes 2, 3, or you can keep the feet on the floor 4. Either way, belly back to spine 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 5 to go. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good job. Side to side. Stretch, stretch, stretch. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Nice job. Okay, we're going to do a vertical lift. Up and down on the toes. If you choose to add the calf raises too. Great for strengthening the ankles. 4, 5, 6. Nice combination move. 7. Remember to add the toes. Heels up. 8. Up and down. 9, 10. Give me 5, 4. Remember to remain tall. 3. Keep your head back. 2, and 1. Side to side. Side to side. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Angled curls. Remember those heels together, toes apart. Draw the inner thighs together. Zip up from the heels. Squeeze the shoulder blades. Squeeze the glutes. And 1, 2. If you want to go up and down on the toes, 3. Keep going with that. 4. Exhale. 5, 6. Angled. 7. Keep them angled. 8. 9, 10, and 5 to go. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Lovely job with the biceps. That was a good 6 sets, different angles, 2 sets of each type. And we've done 2 sets of triceps. We're going to take a quick breather for some water, and then we're going to go into overhead arm extensions for triceps. Oh, that feels good. You got to keep the hydration going, right? So what we're going to do here is pick a couple of medium set weights, or if you're strong, a couple of heavier sets. We're going to parcel them up, crisscross them, take them, put them in a little X, grip that whole package. Most of the fingers on this side and the thumbs on the other side, okay? We're going to raise those arms up by the side and try to bring those elbows in tight to 90 degree. Press 1, 2, 3, 4. Snap. And extend. 5, 6. Have a good grip going over the head. 7. Keep the elbows by your sides. 8. 9. 10. 5 to go. 4, 3, 2, overhead press, okay, overhead press, lip side to side, good, nice job, 4, 3, 2, depending on how heavy that was, you may need a longer break. If you were pushing a lot of weight, your heart rate may be quite elevated, you might need to take a longer break. That's an indication you're working very hard. If you're like, oh no, I can do another 10 right now, right immediately after you finish the first set, I bet we add a little bit more weight. Okay, so here we go, round 2, everything's nice form, elbows in, no arching of the back, chin up off the chest, elbows in nice and tight. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 10, keep those elbows in, give me 5, 4, go arch the back, 3, 2, and 1, nice job, side to side, dip, dip, 5, 6, 7, 9, 8, roll the shoulders back, shoulder bumps. Okay, so that's our bicep and tricep complete. A little bit more water if you're feeling the need. Keep sipping after kind of a couple sets or so, just keep sipping. Alright, I'm going to do some rotator cuff with you. a taper cuff. We can use lightweights, we can use mediums. We can use a band, resistance band, for the outward and the inward, the internal and the external rotation, to strengthen our rotator cuff. So you choose, you can probably go anything up to 5 pounds on that, as long as you don't have an injury. If you have the injury, go light, super light, no weight, or check with your doctor before doing anything that's going to hurt the joint. If you're just wanting to strengthen the rotator cuff, there isn't a problem with it. Some light weights, medium weights, here we go. Pressing out, one, two. So my elbows are glued to my sides, three. You might find it helpful to put the towel under that arm so that it stops you bringing the elbows away from the rib cage. Open, close it. 90 degrees, give me five. Four, abs are tight. Three, two, and one. Can you hold it out there for four? Three, two, bring it down. Alright, so we're going to start with the outward, pushing in the internal rotation. So we're starting here at our maximum output, without the elbows coming away from the sides, and press in one, press in two. Your effort is pushing in, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Five to go. Four, pushing into your sides. Three, two, and one. Yes, side to side dips. Dip, dip, and dip. Four, three, two, and one. So we have the palms open with that internal, external rotation. We're gonna do it vertical now. So you can hold the thumb and the finger on the top of the weight. Let it drop down from there, 90 degrees. External rotation, one. Two, pushing into the rib cage. Three, tall, tall, tall. Four, abs are tight. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Give me five, four, three, two, and one. Okay, lift side to side. So that was the external. We're going to do the internal next. Vertical, left, vertical weight. Pushing in one. Effort's coming in two. Three, stand tall, stand tall. Four, the core is tight. Five, not arching. Six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Give me five, four, three, one, side to side dip, four, eight, seven, six, and five, four, three, two, and one. Good job. Weights and water. We covered a lot on the upper body very fluidly, but we got it all done. We were very focused, and we had two sets of everything. You can add a third set to add more time to it. You can add more weight to make it more intense, so long as you keep the form. The weight is fine, only if you keep the form. If you lose the form, you gotta go back down your weight. There's no point in going, just, I could lift 10, 15 pounds, but your form is terrible. Don't forget that. Keep good form, lighter weight, work your way up slowly. Cheers, drink some water. Okay, let's do a full down stretch for the upper body. All right, so roll the shoulders back. This is my favorite. Shoulder rolls backwards. Not forward, three. Promote good posture, four. Up around and down, five. Six, seven, eight, nine, and ten. We'll follow through with the hands clasped behind the back, my disappearing arm act. Stretching the front of my chest and shoulders. Pulling that back, they're taking a deep breath into the lungs. Pulling the arms, if you can, away from the body to get a nice deep stretch. And right now you picked your favorite hand to pull back. So I want you to, if this is your favorite, switch, grab that way, so that shoulder gets a deeper stretch. Try to pull the hands away from the hips. Four, three, two, and one. We're gonna take a wide stance. And we're gonna do moving eight side bends. Seven modified for shoulders. Six, the arm comes in front. three, two, and one. Go the other way. Four, three, two, and one. Hip side to side, side to side. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and on the flat. Standing cat cow. Flat back, round it. Flat back, round it. Flat back, round it. Flat, round, roll, 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 roll. Nice and tall, arms are extended. Hands pushing back, that's your bicep stretch. Squeeze your shoulder blades up tall. Turn your head to one side, stretch the neck. Keep the arms extended. Center, turn the other way. Hold it. Center, clasp the hands, stretch them up. Nice stretch up at the top. White stance, little side bend. Center, switch. We're going to drop one of those elbows down. Go back, chin up, grab behind the joint. If you're having trouble going up and over, push from here, from the front, and stretch that way. Or, if you have the range of motion, remember this is your back scratch test. Can you still scratch your back? Or did you have to invest in one of those scratchers? Switch, cross. Back scratch test. How are your shoulders doing? Breathing in through the nose. And out through the mouth. Breathe. Stretch an individual shoulder stretch. Pull across the arm, or across the chest. Or four, three, two, and switch, and cross, stretch. Four, three, two, and one. Deep breath. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, down. Inhale, reach up. Exhale it down. Deep breath, inhale. Reach up. Exhale, down. Last one. Reach up. Reach for the sky. This was Body Sculpt upper body workout today. It was my pleasure to be with you. I'm Shirley Steele. Over and out. See you next time.